Update 16 arrived into the Elite Dangerous live game yesterday. It's still early days and there's a fair bit to unpack, so in this video I'm going to go through the major points in the patch notes and everything that the community has uncovered so far. First things first, if you've not already looked at the full patch notes then there are, as is the norm, a fair few squashed bugs listed alongside the new stuff. I won't go through all of them here but there are some community big ticket items in there listed as fixed, such as Thargoid hearts no longer being emissive, fires in Thargoid controlled settlements not being extinguished by venting the atmosphere, inappropriate POIs spawning on previously undiscovered worlds, and bark mounds being wrongly indicated as present in the discovery scanner. One nice little touch, whilst you still can't order a drink at the bar, most but not all of the drinks in the bars at outposts etc now come in containers more suitable to a zero-g environment and feature lids. You'll also note carrier jump times are very exaggerated as I speak these words. This is usually a measure implemented by Frontier to temper the loads on their servers following a patch deployment. Bear with it and it should settle down back to normal in due course. And while we're talking carriers, the price limit on all three of the fleet carriers' marketplaces has been significantly raised to allow for a maximum of 10,000 times the mean galactic price. In theory at least this should mean that fleet carrier owners now have much more of an incentive to sell commodities or importantly things like on foot materials as they can now make decent credit on those sales. I'm curious to see if this makes suit and weapon engineering more accessible for those that don't wish to collect all the mats themselves. From a technical standpoint overall the deployment of the patch went very smoothly. I've linked to the full notes below this video if you want to take a look and see if your favourite bug is no more. Part of the installation yesterday was the deployment of a new spacesuit cosmetic item called the Nomad Liaison Pack, which is available in the store for 16,520 arcs. The headline feature of the suit is far and away its hood and mirrored face mask headgear. No, no pun intended, which seems to have gone down a storm in the community overall. The patch also added a really touching tribute to the lovely Michael Brooks, one of the original developers behind Elite Dangerous who very sadly passed earlier this year. Travel to the Artemis system and seek out the new megaship owned by the newly incorporated organisation Brooks Galactic Tours. Seek out the tourist beacon at the Freeholm station in the system and you can follow the trail to a series of beautiful stunning locations in the game newly marked with a beacon of their own in honour of Michael. If you previously followed the trail of the Dedicant megaship then a message will be waiting for you in your inbox. The Dedicant megaship was chock full of Far God Cult True Chapter adherents who were under armed federal guard aboard the ship when there was a mysterious unscheduled activation of the frameshift drive. A breadcrumb trail recently alluded to the ship's imminent discovery but it wasn't until update 16 that the ship itself was actually added and its location revealed. I'd highly recommend you seek the ship out. I don't want to spoil anything at all so I will say no more for the moment other than there are 10 fully voiced acted logs that can be downloaded and they are without a doubt amongst the best and creepiest in the game that I have ever encountered. If like me you really enjoy this particular feature of Elite Dangerous gameplay you are in for an absolute treat. You'll find the Dedicant in HIP 19600. You may remember the only new feature of update 16 that Frontier would acknowledge ahead of time was the arrival of the Thargoid Hunter class vessel, the Scythe. As I mentioned at the top of this piece it really is early days for this stuff but already there have been a huge amount of reported Scythe encounters and they do seem to be eminently survivable. As a result we know quite a bit about its operations and patterns of behaviour. There's an excellent video by Commander Crunch Buttsteak on YouTube that details what to expect from the Scythe, how it behaves, what its motivations are and, importantly, how to survive an encounter, and it's not nearly as difficult as you might imagine. Thankfully, standing in stark contrast to our first Hunter class encounter experiences when the Glaive arrived in update 15. The Scythe, it seems, really does have a very specific motivation and modus operandi, and it's definitely not something we've seen from the Thargoids before. I won't duplicate the information in Commander Buttsteak's video here, you'll find the video linked below. However, I will say this on the subject of the Scythe itself. Shortly after the patch dropped and the servers went live last night, we started seeing multiple reports coming in of Scythe encounters near but definitely outside of the expected Thargoid war zones. After some investigation it became apparent that the encounters all had one thing in common. The interdicted commanders all had occupied escape pods in the hold of their ships. Our efforts trying to draw a Scythe out without an escape pod in systems outside the war where we knew commanders had been interdicted yielded no results. So if you are particularly Thargoid adverse, don't worry. It seems for the moment at least that if you're not carrying an occupied escape pod, you will be left alone in systems bordering the front line. As soon as we know any more from update 16 we will of course, as always, post it on this very channel. If you enjoyed this video be sure to like and subscribe to make sure you see all our content, and if you'd like to help support our work here at the Buur Pit you can also become a patron just like the wonderful folks you see listed on screen right now and gain access to exclusive perks, content and community events.